and kidneys are vital organs our bodies need. But when we die, we no longer have a use for these organs. Let someone who is struggling to survive have a second chance at life. You can become an organ donor today to help. A story from the Atlantic website. When Adam Baser was 13 years old, he came down with what seemed to be the flu. But when he had trouble breathing and his ankles began to swell, his parents rushed him to the hospital. When they had gotten to the hospital, he had gone into complete heart failure. He was later diagnosed with idiopathic viral cardiomyopathy. This is an unknown virus that attacks the heart. He waited months on the organ transplant list with an LVAD assisting his heart. Finally, after a 4.5 month wait, he finally received the heart transplant he needed. Although Adam was lucky and received the transplant he needed, a lot of people aren't lucky and don't receive the transplants they need. Thousands of people wait on the national organ transplant list every single day. From hearing this story and many stories like it, I believe that people should be required to donate their organs. So why should people register to become a donor? Registering decreases the amount of deaths of people that need organ transplants. Thousands of people are dying waiting on these lists. There are around 116,000 people on the national organ transplant list. There are around 2,000 children on the national organ transplant list. There are around 20 people that die every single day just by waiting on the organ transplant list. Every 10 minutes, one person is added to this list. Around 8,000 deaths occur in the United States every single year because people are waiting on the organ transplant list. Learning how many people need transplants to survive, what organs can be donated. The main organs that are donated for organ transplant recipients are the heart, lungs, pancreas, kidneys, and liver. The most organ transplants are kidney transplants. Those are the most transplants that take place. Although you can donate these main organs, you can also donate your corneas, which are your eyes, bone tissue, and skin. Just one organ donor can save up to 8 people's lives. Organs can help people with certain diseases overcome those diseases. They can make those people stronger, healthier, and live a better, longer life. Now that I've talked about who needs organs and why, how can we register to become a donor? To become a donor, you are basically signing your rights away, saying that once you die, you are willing to give up your organs to people that need them. In most states, when you apply or renew your driver's license, they will ask you if you want to register to become an organ donor, and you sign a form saying that you are willing to give up these organs. You can also register online at the DMV.org. When you register, a little heart will be shown in the corner of your driver's license saying that you are willing to give up these organs. It is important to register because the faster the doctors know you are a donor, the faster they can get those viable organs to people that need them. After a person dies, there is only so much time organs are viable for, so it is important they know as soon as possible if you are an organ donor and if you're willing to do this. Depending on if people die from cardiac or brain damage, there is a different time frame between those. If you die from a cardiac problem, the doctors have a shorter amount of time they can get those viable organs out. If you die from a brain damage problem, they have a longer time that those organs are viable for, and they can get those out with a longer period of time. To save some very important lives today, we can become organ donors. This is one simple step could have an impact on a person's lifetime. So now that you've heard my main points, are you ready to take a step and become an organ donor today? You could save many lives.
Funeral, but that's not true.
sure you can have an open casket funeral for donating organs still.
Do you think the doctors don't try as hard to save you if you are down?
The doctors still try hard, but it's just a matter of if you die from a brain damage or cardiac problem.
All right.